गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. इन द लास्ट क्लासेस वी हैव सीन द चैप्टर एलिप्स अंडर विच वी हैव सीन सम कंसेप्ट ऑफ एलिप्स एंड फॉर्मूला रिलेटेड विद एलिप्स एंड वी हैव सीन सम क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन इट. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट हाइपरबोला. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल सी व्हाट इज हाइपरबोला एंड व्हाट आर द केसेस एंड व्हाट आर इट्स फार्मूला एंड वी विल सी सम क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन इट. ओके, सो व्हाट इज हाइपरबोला स्टूडेंट? सो ए हाइपरबोला इज लोकस ऑफ पॉइंट इन ए प्लेन विच मूव्स in the plane in such a way that the ratio of distance from a fixed point called focus is the same in the same plane to its distance from a fixed line called directrix is always constant, which is always greater than unity. Okay student, that is, this is the point whose distance from this fixed point and this is the fixed line, and the ratio of this and this is always constant, which is greater than unity. Okay students, so this is the definition of hyperbola. Okay, I hope you understand. Now students, we see. Okay students, so this is our hyperbola and this is the directrix and this is our x-axis and y-axis. This is focus S and this is S dash, and this is a point on hyperbola whose distance from S dash and P S dash. Now students, we know that our SP is equal to EPM. So we write SP square is equal to E square PM square. Okay, by the definition of hyperbola, we write SP is equal to EPM and SP square is equal to E square PM square. So student, we can write X minus A whole square plus Y minus 0 whole square is equal to E square. And PM is, student, you know, this PM is, we can write, this is CM minus CN minus CK. Okay, student, so we can write CK whole square. This is C minus CK, which is PN. Okay, so E square or CN is, student, N is X minus CK is A by E whole square. So here, student, we can write X minus A whole square plus Y square is equal to E square X minus A by E whole square. Okay, student. Now when we expand this and solving, we get our result, what? X square by A square minus Y square by A square E square minus 1, which is equal to 1. Okay student, after solving this, we get X square by A square minus Y square by A square E square minus 1, which is equal to 1, where we can write X square by A square minus Y square by B square is equal to 1, where B square is A square E square minus 1. Okay student, and this is the equation of hyperbola. X square by A square minus Y square by B square is equal to 1, where B square is equal to A square E square minus 1. This is the standard equation of hyperbola. Okay students, so in this way we can find out. Now students, some of the concepts are there which we will see. Okay, so we will see, that is so student, our coordinate of center, our center is, student, always 0, 0, and our coordinate of vertices is plus minus a comma 0. Okay student, and coordinate of foci is, student, plus minus a comma 0. Okay, and student, length of terms was axis is equal to 2a. Okay student, this axis is called in case of hyperbola student transverse axis, and this axis is called in case of hyperbola what? Conjugate axis. Okay, so length of conjugate axis is equal to 2b. Okay student, now equation of directrix a is when 2v square by a. Okay student, this is equation of directrix. Sorry, this is lattice rectum. Equation of directrix is when x is equal to plus minus a by a. This is, and length of lattice rectum a student 2b square by a. Okay student, and equation of transverse axis is x axis, so y is equal to 0, and equation of conjugate axis, that is y axis, so equation in x is equal to 0. Okay student, I hope you understand. Now the focal distance now student, difference of focal distance is, that is our S dash P, this minus S P is equal to 2a. Okay student, this will be our difference of focal distance. Now student, this is the case and student, our eccentricity is under root one plus b square by a square. Okay students, so this is our eccentricity in the case when the standard equation is x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1. Okay students, this all formula will be changed in case when the standard equation is x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to minus 1. Okay student, when the standard equation is this, then this axis will rotate, this conjugate axis, this transverse axis will change and conjugate axis like this. This s axis will act as a, and this part will be lie like this, and this part will be lie like this. Okay, my means our major axis either transverse axis will be our y axis. Okay student, so formula will change, our center will be 0 0, and vertices will be what? 0 comma plus minus b. Okay, and this foci will be 0 comma plus minus b e, and the length of transverse axis will be 2b, and length of transverse axis will be 2b, and conjugate axis will be 2a, and equation of directrix will be y is equal to plus minus b by e, and length of lattice rectum is 2a square by b b, and transverse x is equal to 0, and this is y is equal to 0. Okay, student, and this length, distance of focal difference of focal distance, it will be what? B. And eccentricity is okay, friend. So eccentricity we can find in this case, we can write a square is equal to b square, a square minus 1. Okay. So eccentricity will be a square by b square plus 1, which is a square. So a is under root a square plus b square by b square. Okay, student. So this will be our eccentricity in the case this. Okay. When the standard form x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to minus 1. Okay, student. So these are the some concept related with hyperbola, which we have to keep in our mind before solving the questions of this chapter. Okay, student. Now, now student, if the center HK is given of the hyperbola, then the equation of hyperbola will be x minus h whole square by a square minus y minus k whole square by b square is equal to 1. Then the equation of hyperbola will be change. It will be like this. Okay, this is a special case. Okay, now student, we will take some questions of this chapter and we will see. Okay, so student, our first question is, find the equation of hyperbola whose directrix equation of directrix, which is 2x plus y is equal to 1 and focus is 1, 2, and eccentricity student is root 3. So student, our equation of directrix is 2x plus y is 1, focus is this, and eccentricity is this. Okay. Now you know that by the definition of hyperbola, we know SP is equal to EPM. So when we squaring both sides, we get this. Okay. So if we are taking a point PXY on the parabola, hyperbola, so we get x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to e square, which is root 3 whole square, and PM, which is 2x plus y minus 1 under root 2 square plus 1 whole square to the whole square. Okay, student, so this is SP square is equal to E square PM square. Okay. Now, student, we are going to expand this, so we are getting x square plus 1 minus 2x, y square plus 4 minus 4y, which is 3, and this term is spent. We can write this 4 plus 1, 5, which is 5, and this is, we are applying a plus b plus c whole square. So we write student 4x square plus y square plus 1 plus 4xy minus 2y and minus 4x. Okay student, now this is our 3 by 5. So when we multiply this to the left hand side, we get student 5x square 5y square 10x minus 20y, and this is 4 and 1 5, 5 5s are 25. And multiply this 3 with inside, so we get 12x square and 3y square, and this is 12xy and minus 12x and minus 6y and plus 1, which is 3. Okay student, now student, we will send this to the left hand side and get our result. Okay, so 12x square minus 5x square, 3y square minus 5y square. Okay student, 12xy minus, and here minus 12x, so send this, plus 10x minus 6y student, send this, plus 20y plus 3 student, and this is minus 25, which is equal to 0. Now when we further solve it student, we get 2y square, and this is 12xy and minus 2x and plus 14y minus 22 is equal to 0. Okay student, so student, this is the required equation of hyperbola which we have to find out from the given information. Okay student, I hope you understand. Now let's see once again, we have to given that the equation of directrix, which is 2x plus y is equal to 1, and focus 1, 2, and eccentricity. So then you know that if a point we are taking here, and this is our point of focus, and this is a point M, and this is our directrix 2x plus y minus 1 is equal to 0. So by the definition of this, you know it will be the equal to the constant, which is greater than 1, and the constant is equal to the ratio of SP by PM, okay, and that is equal to a constant E, and which is greater than 1. Okay students, so you know we can write SP square is equal to EPM square. Okay, so student, now we can write x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to E. Our eccentricity is given to us, which is root 3, so we can write root 3 whole square, and our PM is 2x plus y minus 1 under root 2 square plus 1 square to the whole square. Okay students, so now we can expand this, we write a square plus b square minus 2ab. Again we are expanding this, we write a square plus b square minus 2ab, which is equal to 3, and this is student our root 4 plus 1, which is the squaring of this, so this is 5. So when a plus b plus c whole square, so this is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc and plus 2ca. When we expand this, we get this. Now then we are multiplying with this 5 here and multiplying with this 3 inside the bracket, we get this equation. Okay, now student, when we transpose here, send this side to this side, after subtracting we are getting 7x square minus 2y square plus 12xy minus 2x plus 14y minus 22 is equal to 0, and this is student our required equation of hyperbola. Okay, I hope you understand students. Now we take another question. Okay, let our next question is to end. Our equation of hyperbola is given to us 16x square minus 9y square is equal to 144. Okay, student. For the following hyperbola, find the length of transverse and conjugate axis, eccentricity. We have to find length of conjugate axis, length of transverse axis, coincident, and eccentricity, coordinate of foci vertices, eccentricity, coordinate of foci and vertices. Okay, student, and equation of directrix, equation of directrix. Okay, student, so this from the given equation of hyperbola, we have to find the following things. Okay, we have to find the length of conjugate axis, length of transverse axis, what is eccentricity, the coordinate of foci, the coordinate of vertices, and equation of directrix. Okay, student, so these are the things, and student, let us write them also. Let us write down. These are the things which we have to find out from the given equation of hyperbola. Okay, student. So first of all, student, we will change this equation of hyperbola in the form of standard form. Okay, which is our x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1. So first of all, we will change this in the standard form. For this, student, we write 16x square by 144, 9y square by 144, and this is 1. We are sending this 144 to the left hand side in denominator, and we get in right hand side is 1. So then x square by this is 9, and y square by this is 16, which is equal to 1. Okay, student. So student, where our a square is 9 and our b square is 16. Okay, now student, we have to find the equation of directrix, vertices, focus, eccentricity, length of transverse axis, conjugate axis. Okay, student, so student, we are seeing that this is our first case, because this is the type x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1. This is not the type x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to minus 1. Okay, so this is our first case. So length of transverse axis is 2a, strength. So this is 3, which is equal to 6. Length of conjugate x is 8. First one, so eccentricity is, student, you know p square is equal to a square minus 1. So from here we can find out our b square by a square plus 1 e square. Okay student, so eccentricity is a is equal to under root 1 plus b square is 16 and e square is 9, so it will be 5/3. Okay student, now student, foci is, the coordinate of foci is plus minus a comma 0, so student plus minus a, our a is student 3, 5/3 comma 0, so this will be written as 5 comma 0. Okay, and student, our vertices is, you know the coordinate of vertices is a0, so this is, and our a is 3, so this is plus minus 3 comma 0. I hope you understand students. Now our length of lattice rectum is, equation of directrix is first, equation of directrix, x is equal to plus minus a by e. So plus minus a is 3, and by e is 5/3, so x is 9/5. And student, equation of lattice rectum is 2b square by a, so which is 2, b square is 9 and a is 5, so a is 3, b square is 16, sorry, and this will be 32/3. Okay student, so our equation of directrix is x is equal to plus minus 9/5 and length of lattice rectum is 32/3 and eccentricity is 5/3, foci is plus minus 5/0, vertices is 3,0, and length of transverse axis is 6 and conjugate axis is 8. Okay, I hope you understand students. So in such type of question student, we will first, it is very important to that the concept must be clear, in which case what will be the length of lattice rectum, what will be the foci, what will be the vertices, what will be the transverse axis, and eccentricity and equation of directrix and length of lattice rectum. So the formula is very important in such type of question student. If you are knowing the concept and formula, then you can solve such type of question easily. Okay, because these are very simple questions, but just we are changing this equation in the standard form and comparing and getting our A and B, and on the basis of all formula we can easily calculate these all required things. Okay, so if you have not learned the formula, then you will not be able to understand such type of question. Okay students, now we will take another question. Our next question is 3x square plus, sorry, minus 6y square is equal to minus 18. So we have to find the equation of, we have to change this in the standard form, okay? So then we divide this 3x square by 18, and 6y square is minus 18, which is equal to minus 1. So we can write x square by 6, y square by, this is, okay students, so this is our second case, okay, when the transverse axis is on y axis, okay, so this is our standard equation. So students, now we will see some other questions in the next class, so thank you so much for today.